Good morning, students. Today we are going to start our next topic, that is law of constant proportions. Before starting this topic, let us recall that we have done in last video from the chapter Atoms and Molecules. We have done about the views given by the ancient philosophers and the first law of chemical combinations, that is law of conservation of mass. Here we are going to start the law of constant proportions today. As it means, you can see the name of this law, law of constant proportions. Constant means fixed, proportions means amount. It means this law deals with the proportion, amount of the substances present in a chemical substance, whether in the form of percent, whether in the form of grams. According to the scientist Lavoisier, he also stated the same thing. He noted down that in a compound which is composed of two or more different types of elements, the type of elements present in that compound is same, whether that compound is taken from any source, whatever is its origin, and whatever is the method to prepare it. To understand this, let us take the example. First example I am using is of water, H2O. Water, you all know its formula is H2O, means two atoms of hydrogen combined to form, two atoms of hydrogen combines with one atom of oxygen to form water. And in this case, if you are getting the water from tap or you are getting the water from any well, or whether it is rainwater, whether it is formed by any chemical reaction, would there be the difference in the formula of water? Answer is no. It will always be H2O. It means every time, whatever is the source of water, the two atoms of hydrogen will combine with one atom of oxygen to give water. In the same manner, you can see another example, carbon dioxide. In the same way, carbon dioxide also have different sources. Like we are exhaling carbon dioxide, the carbon dioxide which is present in the atmosphere, or with any chemical reaction, if we are preparing carbon dioxide. In the three cases, the formula of carbon dioxide will always be CO2. It will not differ any time. One carbon and two oxygen will combine to form carbon dioxide. And this is what this law states. According to the statement of the law of constant proportion, in a chemical substance, elements are present in definite proportion by mass. This is what they told. In a definite proportion by mass. Definite means fixed. Proportion means amount. By mass, what does it mean? It means mass of hydrogen and oxygen is also fixed in water. Let us check the ratio of hydrogen and oxygen in water by mass. To find the ratio by mass, we must write the symbols of elements. Actually, we will introduce you symbols about their atomic numbers, about their atomic masses in the next topic, next part of the chapter. Here it is a just general touch to tell you what is the meaning here by mass. We will repeat it again, so please take it. Hydrogen and oxygen, these are the two elements which are involved in the formation of water. The mass of hydrogen is 1 and mass of oxygen is 16. But we know how many atoms of hydrogen are present over there? 2. So into 2. So you will get 2:16, and convert it into lower terms, you will get 1:8. It means in case of water, the ratio by mass is always 1:8. From where you are getting water, it doesn't matter. And in this is the same case for carbon dioxide. Let us find the ratio by mass of carbon dioxide. Write the symbols of elements present here, carbon and oxygen. Don't worry, beta, because you don't know the masses, no worries. You will just come to know about the masses and many more things by the end of this chapter. So I am writing the mass of carbon. The mass of carbon is 12 and mass of oxygen is 16. But we know how many atoms of oxygen are participating to form carbon dioxide? 2. So we have to multiply it by 2. So you get 12:32. Convert it into lower terms. This is 3:8. Means ratio by mass of carbon dioxide is 3:8, and it will be fixed always whenever, from wherever you obtain carbon dioxide. It doesn't depend upon the source or method of preparation of carbon dioxide, and this is true for the all the compounds. This is law of constant proportions. Now let us solve few numericals on the basis of the same law. First of all, very simple numerical, that is, the statement is in front of you. Hydrogen and oxygen combine in the ratio of 1:8. And how this 1:8 ratio comes, I just told you. Now, 1:8 by mass to form water. What mass of oxygen gas would be required to react completely with 3 gram of hydrogen gas? First of all, they informed you that hydrogen and oxygen combines in the ratio of 1:8. Now, what is the change? Before going with this change, let us understand the meaning of this 1:8. It means 1 gram of hydrogen combines with 8 gram of oxygen to form water. So here it is, its solution. 1 gram of hydrogen combined with 8 gram of oxygen. Now, what was our question? Question was that what mass of oxygen would be required to react completely with 3 gram of hydrogen. Now, instead of 1 gram, hydrogen is provided to you is 3 gram. So let us find what amount of oxygen will be combined. If 1 gram of hydrogen combined with 8 gram of oxygen, ratio will be same. So if hydrogen is 3 times, then of course the amount of oxygen will also become 3 times of this. So 3 gram of oxygen will combine with 24 gram of oxygen. So in this way, if we find the ratio 3:24, you will get 1:8. It means same. It means if 3 gram of oxygen combines with 24 gram of oxygen, ratio obtained is 1:8. It means our answer is correct. Let us go to the next numerical. This is our next question. Here in this, you have a sample whose value is 24 gram of a compound, any compound that is made up of boron and oxygen. It is given to us, any compound which is made up of two types of elements, that is boron and oxygen, and the amount is, total amount is 24 gram. 0.24. Okay, you can see here. On analysis, what is found? 0.096 gram of boron and 0.144 gram of oxygen is combined to give 0.24 gram of compound. Here are the values that are given in the statement. Mass of compound, this much. Boron, this much. Oxygen, this much. Now our question is calculate the percentage. They are not telling us to find the ratio. They are asking the percentage. So to find the percentage, generally in maths, what you do to find the percentage? For example, you are obtaining the percentage of marks obtained in any subject. Say science. You have obtained 80 marks out of 100, means total. And what you do? You write obtained marks at the numerator place, and 100 means maximum marks at denominator place, and multiply it by 100 and you get the percentage. So here in the same manner, we are going to find the percentage of boron. Here total amount is 0.024. So it will be here, and mass of element whose percentage is to be found should be written here. So 0.096 over 0.24 gram into 100 and you obtain 40%. In the same manner, you can find about the oxygen also. Mass of oxygen, mass of compound, that is 0.144 gram over 0.024, because total sample is 0.24 gram into 100, you obtained the percentage. This is how you can find the percentage of different elements. Now, one more example, let us discuss. Here, what you are provided with, 5 gram of calcium is burnt in 2 gram of oxygen. And you are getting 7 gram of calcium oxide. When 5 gram of calcium is burnt in 2 gram of oxygen and 7 gram of calcium oxide is obtained. Now our question is, what mass of calcium oxide will be produced when 5 gram of calcium is burnt in 20 gram of oxygen? Difference lies here. Oxygen was 2 gram initially, now oxygen is 20 gram. But the amount of calcium is same, and they are asking ki how much calcium oxide will be obtained. So we must recall the law of constant proportion, that proportion is fixed every time. If 5 gram of calcium is combining with 2 gram, whether oxygen is provided 20 gram, whether it would be 10, it would be 50, but it will always combine with the 2 gram only and it will give 7 gram. If the value of calcium is changed, say 5, suppose it's doubled, 5 to 10, then the amount of oxygen will also be doubled. We have to check the percentage or ratio, so that its ratio must comes the same. So let us discuss its answer now again. And another question, which law of chemical combination will govern your answer? Because we are talking about the amount of substances that are used to form that compound. It means we are talking about the proportions. That's why the law concerned is law of constant proportion. In both cases, mass of calcium is 5. Mass of oxygen taking part will be same in both cases. Every time, first if it is 2, then again, out of 20, only 2 gram of oxygen will combine with 5 gram of calcium to form 7 gram of calcium oxide. There will be no change in the product, and out of 20, 2 gram is used, 18 gram of oxygen will be left unreacted. It means it will be there, but no reaction will take place. It will combine with only 2 gram of oxygen. I hope you all are well clear. Now our topic is over. Thank you.